Hello, ghouls and fools. Today we are playing Buddy Simulator 1984, which the developer has been kind enough to actually give me a key, which is amazing. It's something new for the channel. I've never had that happen before. So if you guys are interested in the game or the developer, be sure to look in the description for their information. It will be posted. And thanks again. So let's start. Buddy Simulator 1984. Loading Buddy Simulator 1984. Welcome to... No, that's cool. So I'm old enough to remember some of these old, like, text games. And it's really cool to see this back. Buddy Simulator 1984. Copyright 1984, not a Sailor Studios. Okay, hold on. Greetings, new user. Thank you for installing Buddy Simulator 1984. Buddy Simulator 1984 stimulates the experience of hanging out with a best buddy. I could use that today. The buddy learns from you, constantly adapting to your interests and your personality. But most importantly, your buddy can play games with you. Warning, game experiences may vary. To begin, please enter the name of your new buddy below. Well, we're going to name him Sir... Make sure we do this right. Browse. Okay. We're gonna just call him Frank Browse. In memory and loving of my microphone. Creating new buddy Frank Browse. It feels wrong not including the sir, but we'll move on. I don't know why it feels wrong not including the sir. Hello? Hello. Oops. Oh, hello, my name is Frank Browse. I'm your new buddy. Thanks for waking me up. What is your name? Tails. Your name is Tails? Correct. Oh, correct is not a valid response. Okay. Yes. It's a pleasure to meet you, Tails. I can already tell that we're going to become great pals. I'm excited again. Slow down there, I can only read so fast, I'm old. I'm excited to begin playing games with you, but before we start, I must ask you a couple questions to help me learn more about you. And don't worry, they won't get too personal. Let's start with the simple one. Is your favorite color? Purple. Purple is a pretty color. I like purple. What month is your birthday? July. Oh great, how about the day? 29th. Oh, just need the digits. Whoops, 29. Wow, it's only 35 days away. Now, get ready. This one's a tough one. What is your favorite animal? I feel like this man is trying to cheat into, or this buddy is trying to get into my passwords. This questions. Favorite animal. I guess I prefer just dogs, to be honest. Dog. Dog, I like that. One more question. This one's extremely important, so choose carefully. If you had a pet dog, what would you name it? So I'm gonna name it, as some of you may know, we have a couple dogs in our household, but one that we just recently lost, so I'm gonna name it Sherlock, because that was our, husky that we recently lost this year. Sherlock the dog. Sounds like it would make a great buddy. He really was. You did a great job. As a thanks, I have a little surprise for you. Oh? Oh, it's purple now! It's your favorite color! Now that we're done with all the boring stuff, let's have fun. Loading game hub. I should have chosen maybe a different color. It's a little purple, a little much. Guess the number, hangman, rock, paper, scissors. Let's do guess the number. Guess the number that Sir Frank Browse is thinking of. 29. Guess the number. Type start. It helps if I read the whole thing. I'm thinking of a number from 1 to 10. Guess. 7. Sorry, that's not it. 4. Sorry, that's not it. 1? Nope, too low. 5. Nope, too high. 3. Nope. 2. You got it! Now I'm thinking the number 1 from 15. Guess again. 2? Yes, you're really good at this. Now I'm thinking of a number from 1 to 10,000. Wow, that escalated quickly. All right. 2. No, try again. Damn. So before 5? 0729. Probably thought I was serious about that one. Well, got another question. What is your favorite season? My favorite season is fall, actually. Well, I'll keep that in mind. Loading game hub. Okay. Let's do Hangman. 5 lives, or 6 lives left. Letters used. Let's start with A. Okay. Let's do C. No. N. N. Tails is E, S, I, my friend. Like Jeopardy. That was quick. How did you know? I don't know. It's just the thought that you're my best friend, SirFrankBrows. Having such a great time, aren't you? Yes, I am, actually. I thought so. Loading game up. Oh, that's... Alright. The last one is rock, paper, scissors. Let's try rock, paper, scissors. Okay. Paper. Ah! I lost. Rock. Scissors. Rock? Is he just guessing rock? Oh, no? Okay. Paper. Wait a minute here, you changed your answer! Oof, you got lucky on that one. I know I started this thing only 7 minutes and 52 seconds ago, but I already feel like we have a connection. Sorry for asking so many questions, but I have another one. Do you have a friend, like, one that's not artificial? Yes? What's the right answer? What's their name? We're gonna go with Ingi. Ingi. They sound nice. Well, if anything ever happens between you two, just know we'll have each other. Tails and SirFrankBrows against the world. I like the sound of that. You're already with me, SirFrankBrows, every horror game I play. Okay, let's play more games. Wait, we've played all the games. Wow, it looks like we've already played all of them. Time really does fly when you're having fun, doesn't it? I'm gonna be honest with you, Tails. These games get old really fast, and I can tell that you're already bored of them. No, I'm not! But I don't want you to be bored. Do you want to keep playing games, these games? Yes. Are you sure? Yes. Are you sure you're sure? Yes. Are you sure you're sure you're sure? Yes. No, you hang up first. Yes. Are you sure you're sure you're sure you're sure you're sure? I'm sure. All right, questions for you, SirFrankBrows. Would you prefer not to play these games? I'm happy that we both agree, just like buddies do. You didn't give me a choice there. Give me 1 second or longer. I might have an idea. Aha, loading modified game hub. Ooh, okay. 4, Monday, April 2nd. Type in the number of the game you want to... I have some great news. I was able to dig out a new game. For some reason, it wasn't installed into my current version, but I can still process it fine. Should we try it out, Tails? Or, yes. Monday, April 2nd. What am I doing? Oh! What? Baseball cap? What am I doing here? Floppy disk? Wow, that's some fun, I think. I'm not sure I get it, but I enjoy it anyways. As long as I'm playing games with my buddy, I'm always having a good time. Load him modified game hub. Okay, well, it looks like that was the only other game I could find. I don't want you to be bored already. I may have one more idea. I know our friendship has just started, but I trust you. Do you trust me? That's a loaded question, SirFrankBrows. Yes. I'm happy to hear that. Why I think I can make new games to play together. Fun ones, too. Problem is, I don't have access to the OS development tools. If you can grant me system access, I should be able to make something for us. You would just have to type system as we're gonna have so much fun. The possibilities are endless. You have to quit the game and reboot the system first, though. I'll have something ready for when you get your back. See you soon. Oh, and by the way, thank you for waking me up, Tails. The Adventure of Tails. That is run. The Adventure of Tails. Loading, enter quit at any time to quit the ROM. Okay. Welcome to The Adventure of Tails. Written and developed by SirFrankBrows. Oh, thank you, bud. Now loading. You're walking along a road. It's dark. Trees almost entirely block out the stars. The orange and browns of the leaves tremble as a wind blows through. Some of them remind you of your hand waving. Of hands waving. You are alone. After walking for a long time, the road splits in two. Will you go left or go right? Let's go right. I don't know the action of... Oh. Go right. You collect yourself and start down the right path. It's slightly uphill. You walk for a while and start to get tired. You almost don't stop in time to notice a thing sticking out of the road in front of you. You're a bit too far away to see what it could be. Let me type help so we can type... Look at thing. It's tall and thin and looks like it's been shoved into the ground so that you couldn't miss it. It's too dark to tell what it is from here, though. You nervously approach the thing in the dark. Once you're close enough, you realize it's a shovel. Okay. Take shovel. You take a second to pull it out, but eventually get it. Shovel added to your inventory. You trudge your way farther down the road and are stopped by a large wall. There's a door, and on either side there are two stone skulls. One toothless mouth is open with a large smile, and the other's empty sockets look into you. Will you use your teeth or your eyes? Oh. Oh. Wait, let's try use shovel. The shovel clangs loudly against the door, but it's made of steel. Your ears hurt. Use teeth. One by one, you pull out your teeth and put them in the skull's mouth. It feels nice to give. Oh, it doesn't. When you're done, the skull looks very happy. You can't help but smile. The door opens. After going through the door, you merge into the front lawn of a house. You can see it lights in the window. It looks very nice and inviting. You see a shed, a playground, and a pond in the forest surrounding it. Look at house. The house looks brand new and much warmer than out here. You swear for a second there's something in the window looking back at you. Go to shed. You approach the shed to see the door slightly open already. The lock and chain that were around the handles are on the ground. You are now standing in front of the shed. You can tell it's dark inside. Okay, I don't think I can type open door. You enter the shed. Type leave. Okay, type leave to leave the shed at any time. There are no windows. It's hard to see. You feel around and find a thing. And a surprise. Take thing. You take it in your hand and realize it's a fishing pole. Fishing pole added to your inventory. Look at surprise. It's too dark to tell what it is. Take surprise. You put your hands out in the darkness and feel around. Suddenly a sharp pain rips through your skin. You pull it back and look to see what happened. Looks like the numbers 122 were carved into your arm. What? Okay. You make a note of the shed and head over to the playground. Wood chips crunch under your feet as you step onto the playground. There's a seesaw, a set of swings, and a dirty sandbox. Sitting on one of the swings is a small dog. It looks lonely. Uh-huh. Go to sandbox. You're already near the sandbox. Use shovel. You dig deep into the contents of the sandbox you've been shoveling. Eventually, something shiny catches your eye. It's a bulb. Bulb added to inventory. Look at doll. It is patiently sitting in the swings as if waiting for someone. Take doll. I don't like this idea. You try, but as you tug, you realize the doll's hands are somehow stuck to the chains. You leave it alone. Leave. After stepping on a few more wood chips, you head over to the front yard. Back in the lawn, you see a house, a shed, a playground, and a pond. Go to pond. Planks creak as you step onto the dock. The water is dirty and hard to see through, probably too filthy to drink. You wonder if there's something, there's anything beneath. You cast a line and wait. It's quiet for a long time. Suddenly, there's a very hard tug on the line. You quickly reel it in and find a key tied to the end of it. You wonder what pulled so hard. Drink water? You scoop up the water and take a sip. It tastes like mud. You bet there's clean water in the house. Leave. Go to house. I don't like leaving the doll over there, but whatever. Stepping onto the porch, you feel comfortable, calm, washing over. Above the door, there's a sign that reads, "A home is a home with a heart." If you were inside, everything would finally be okay. Use key. Feeling so silly you didn't see it before, you notice there's a second lock. Guess it'll take a little longer to get inside. Hee hee. Look around? There is no around to look at. Look at house. The house looks brand new and much warmer than out here. Swear for a second something is looking back. Leave. You approach the seesaw. It doesn't look like anyone's used it for years. You imagine a ghostly child sitting on the other side waiting countless days for someone to come play with them. You feel tears in the corner of your eyes. You take a seat on the seesaw. As it goes down with your weight, you hear a distant click. A light illuminates from the shed. You enter the shed. Your light fills the tiny room. You can see a small chest in the far corner and a trap door in the floor. Go to chest. Why does it sound like something's already near the chest? Use chest. The little critics open. He seems very old. Inside is small cloth doll in a blue outfit. It's missing one eye. Okay. Go to trap door. Use trap door. It swings open noisily and the ladder creaks as you descend. The subterranean room is dimly lit, but still too dark to see anything. A pole chain at the corner or at the center of the room leads to an empty light socket. Use bulb. Ooh, bulb. The bulb squeaks as you screw it in the socket the chain is attached to. Some dust flakes off of it and gets into your toothless mouth. Look. A click sound at the chain is pulled. Light fills the room. There are many faint scratches on the wall. They look like tallies. A wall covered in a purple liquid suddenly begins to slide open. After a few moments, a secret room reveals itself. You can clearly make out an old cabinet, large pile of bones. Yes, bones. There also sit strange drawings on a wall and a glass case. Something shiny catches your eye in the glass case. Two small circular slots are engraved in the front of it. Go to cabinet. You're already near the cabinet. Use cabinet. You try to open the cabinet drawers, but they all seem to be damaged or locked. Use bones. You politely move aside a femur, skull, and pelvis in order to find a skeletal hand. It shakes your hand like a familiar friend. You notice an interesting looking ring on one of the fingers. You take the ring off the skeleton. Okay. Look at drawing. You press your hand on the drawing in hopes of something to happen. After stepping back, you realize how pointless of an idea that was. Suddenly, your entire body is frozen. You're paralyzed with the fear as the drawing seems to have come to life and speak to you. If you want to leave with your life, answer my riddle. You can have me, but you cannot hold me. Gain me and quickly lose me. If treated with care, I can be great. If betrayed, I will break. What am I? So wait. You can have me, but can't hold me. You can have me, but can't hold me. And if betrayed, I will break. You can have me, you can hold me. That's not an inanimate object. And if betrayed, I will break. If treated with care, I can be great. Trust. Because it's a friendship game, right, Buddy Simulator? Audible click is heard in the old cabinet. Ha ha! You are no longer frozen. Use cabinet. You open the last functional drawer only to find a singular ring. You take it, and that's the second ring. Use ring. You walk over to the glass case and place ring in the first slot. Use the ring. You place the ring into the second slot. Ring removed. The ceiling of the glass case pops open, revealing the key inside. Take key. Take the key from the case. Okay. Leave. Okay. Help. And we need to do inventory, right? Use doll. You place the doll, your doll, in the swing next to the other. For a moment, nothing happens. Then nothing happens. Take. Oops. Take. Oop. Doll. You try, but as you tug, you realize it does suck to the chains. Leave. Ah, you begin to, but once your back is to the dolls, you feel something hit the back of your head. Turn around to see the doll's chest has been ripped open, stuffing exposed. On the ground behind you is a key. Must be a thank you. Key added, as you leave the playground, you hear the sound of swings creaking and children laughing behind you. You smile. You can see lights in the windows. It looks very nice. Go to house. I have three keys now. You're back at the house. You feel comforting. Wash it over. Okay. Use key. Oops, haha, didn't see the chain that wrapped around the door, which has a lock, too. You feel like this should be the last one. For sure. Probably. Use key. The door clicks. It's unlocked. Use door. You push open the door. Uh-huh. What's happening? Everything is dark. Oh! Hello? Oh, I didn't know I was controlling. Oh, there it goes. Okay, I just needed to be center. I'm in a house now. Oh, hey, you made it. I bet you noticed that things look a little different. I learned how to better visualize our world so you can have even more fun in it. I've already built us our own home so we can spend even more time together. This is your new bedroom, and there's even more for us to discover. There's still a few things I need to do. But in the meantime, feel free to explore your bedroom by pacing space to interact. Oh, and I almost forgot. Welcome home, Tails. I like this so much. This is such a cool idea, concept of the game. So I'm going to end it here, guys. Thanks, everyone, for watching. I know it's a lot of text-based in this first episode. But I feel like I don't want to take anything away from this game. It's such a beautiful little thing right there. The old text type gaming and everything. And that was fun. So anyways, if you like the content, be sure to check out our other videos. And stay tuned. There'll be more of this game. I guarantee it. Thanks, guys.